Hi, Philly Key Sports here, Fight TV. Here with Greg Hackett, Mr. Philly Boxer over here. He's a pro boxer. So, we'll talk about tonight's fight. Belt Boxing came to the Blue Horizon. First fight of the night, Jamal the Truth Davis was the unanimous decision of a player, Sonny Bono Taylor. Six-round fight. Greg, what you think of that?
Jamal started off a little slow, but then he picked it up in the fourth round. A little kid rushed on. The guy was about, he was awkward with, you know, very long, random, going to punch him behind the head. But it was a good fight. Jamal did it in the boots.
Yeah, here's that. I think Jamal, you know, picked it up towards the end. Bono came out a little bit stronger, kind of like in the survival mode. He just kind of hung on it and get knocked out. Good win for Jamal Davis. Let's see what he got coming up next. All right, second we had junior lightweights Derek Bivens and Luis Smurfus-Willen in a nice little four-round super featherweight fight that ended in a draw.
Yeah.
So, Greg?
You already know I was a big man of nothing. That fight shouldn't have been me, but it was. It was a good fight, very entertaining. Derek did everything he had to do, but also Smurf did what he had to do. You know what I mean? But it was a good fight. It was banging the whole fight. It was a draw. I gave it a draw.
Yeah, I had it a draw too. I mean, it was close. A lot of good two-way action in that fight, man. Both fighters came to fight. Bivens had his nose busted up a little bit early, sucked it up, and came out. You know, good show hard for both fighters. Hope to see them both again.
Right.
All right, third fight of night, super middleweights. Dennis the Assassin Haslam wins a unanimous decision over Garrett the Ultimate Warrior Wilson. It was a pretty damn good super middleweight fight, I thought.
Dennis Assassin had what he had to do with boxing. He couldn't do it anymore because he was fighting some, like, very wild. He came with an awkward style. Dennis, I gave him his props, but he did what he had to do. He was fighting a hard puncher. You know what I mean? I remember a game from MJ. I seen him knock some teeth off. But he did what he had to do, sticking his jab, stuck it out.
I thought it was a solid performance by Hassan. Like you said, Wilson, man, like he was coming out with them wild man hooks. Which brings up a little bit of a question at ringside. Is it Wilson's got that good of a chin, or is Hassan lack a little bit of pop? Because he nailed Wilson with some good right hands.
Yeah,
and, you know,
cool.
Wilson didn't, you know, step back too
far.
But that remains to be seen, you know. With that being said, good win for Dennis Hassan. Alright, after that we had a surprise upset in what I thought was an early candidate, I don't want to say fight of the year, but at least the last round could have been a round of the year. With Lightning Rod Salka from Pittsburgh wins a unanimous decision over Philly's Victor Vasquez. Swept the scorecard 60-54 across the board. There's some two-way action.
He was a real good fighter. He came ready. He was in top shape. He was in the best shape I've seen in a long time. And he did what he had to do. He kept his punches coming. Punches in variety too, he threw out two punches. Kept Victor Vasquez thinking about it. You know, what he had to do.
Yeah, Victor Vasquez early, you know, South got to boxed a little bit. Victor was able to draw him into more of a street fight, and Rod held his own in that type of fight too.
Yeah.
So, you know, good win for Rod South. Could take nothing away from Victor Vasquez.
He might have a future in Philly.
Yeah. The crowd seems to love that Victor Vasquez. Keep your head up, Vic. You know, we'll see you again soon.
Yeah.
So, alright, then we came down the stretch of the co-main event. Tion the Technician Kennedy takes a majority decision over Andre Wilson from Missouri. Tion Kennedy hit the deck for the first time in his career, but he sucked it up, came back, you know.
He fought a southpaw who his whole plan was to retreat and fire, you know what I mean? So he got caught with a surprise straight left hand. He went straight down, you know what I mean? But he got right back up, showed hard. Jumped right back on the guy, you know, hurt him with a whole lot of body shots, but he couldn't get a lot of it. You know, he was fighting a tough fight, you know what I mean? But he definitely didn't be able to show the Philly side, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that was a good boxing match, I thought. Kennedy showed a lot. I mean, he came off the deck, like they said, had a pretty bad cut over his right eye. You know, the blood was leaking. He didn't let that bother him. He did what he had to do. And give Wilson his props, too, man. He came to fight as he came in his opponent, you know what I mean? Had to, you know, fight his ass off to get even a majority decision tonight. And, you know, both might deserve what they got. So, good fight to both fighters. All right, for the main event. MJ, Mike Jones. He gave the people once again what they wanted to see when he knocked out Dario Salas three times in a vicious second round, man.
Vicious. Dude, like I was saying, he's the hardest worker, so he earned it, you know what I mean? Dude came in here, he wasn't the top-notch duck, you know, he was better than a duck, you know, because he was trying, but he just got caught with some good punches and got knocked out, man.
Yeah, Salas, he's fought a laundry list of top fighters, came in with 31 wins, 25 knockouts. He knocks people out and gets knocked out. Tonight he was on the wrong end of a couple of bad left hooks, and then, man, final third knockdown, just another left hook, and put him down. And MJ retains the NABF welterweight title. Somebody, yo, some TV executive, put him on TV. HBO, Showtime, ESPN.
HBO, I need him.
Stop putting them scrubs on. Get Mike Jones on. All right, in the cleanup battle tonight, junior middleweights, Cassine the Nightmare Wilson takes the unanimous decision over the well-traveled Martinez Clay. It was a pretty good two-way fight. It looked like Cassine, you know, could have had him in spots. Clay, you know, journeyman, knows all the tricks in the book. Held his own, too. What was your take on that fight?
Cassine started strong. I actually thought he was going to stop one, too. But, you know, being a smooth fighter, you know, he's good with boxing. So when he seen that, you know, the guy could take his punches, he started boxing. Does what he do. And that's smooth, he's being smooth in the ring, so, you know, did what he had to do.
Yeah, that's right. Looks like you've seen Wilson's back after a little bit of a layoff. That's two straight wins. And anybody out there thinks they're a junior middleweight, go get Martinez Clay a call because he'll test you out and see what you're made of. So, another good night at the Blue Horizon. Pelz Boxing's return to the Blue Horizon after about 6, 7, 8 years. We'll see him again May 1st, I believe it is, in the same building. Until then, check out PhillyKeith.com with Greg Hackett.
All right.